Story behind the new better than expected jobs report. According to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, 288,000 people were hired in June, dropping the national unemployment rate to 6.1%. But if you're among the 9.5 million still looking for work, you're probably wondering if you're doing something wrong. Financial expert Gene Marks of the Marks Group is here to help us narrow our search and focus on where these jobs are. Thanks for coming in, Gene.
Hey, Joyce, great to see you.
Okay, so where did these new jobs come from that experts didn't even expect to see?
Sure thing. And first of all, Joyce, isn't it great for the past few years you and I have been talking about the bad economy, and now we finally caught up and have replaced all the jobs. And, you know, the surprise really came from the retail sector, construction sector as well. I mean, construction has been doing quite well in this country, stronger than expected. Hospitality jobs have come in as well, and also in the technology areas as well. All of the, really across the board, just about every industry experienced some type of an increase in jobs this past quarter, and that's really great news for the economy.
Really? Well, what kinds of jobs or what kinds of companies are hiring in our region?
Well, you know, Philadelphia actually has not done so bad either. I mean, our unemployment rate is about the same as what it is across the country, so that's a good thing. And look, when you're in Philadelphia, Joyce, I mean, the strongest industries are education and healthcare, also in technology as well. There are some really great technology sectors around West Philadelphia. Those guys have been hiring. North 3rd Street, or Nerd Street, as a lot of people like to call it, also been hiring a lot of startups in that area as well. So healthcare has been big, technology has been big, and also, you know, education, some of the universities as well. All of that has ancillary businesses that support them, Joyce, like construction. So people that are looking for jobs in that area have definitely benefited.
But Gene, people say, I don't qualify for them. What do we need to do to get these jobs?
You know, I mean, qualifications and skills, of course, are very, very important. But, you know, Joyce, you know, as an employer myself with 10 employees, I mean, I'm always looking for people to hire, and I know a lot of clients do the same thing. You got to network a lot more. I want to recommend one site in the area called meetup.com, M-E-E-T-U-P.com. It's an area where you can go and search for meetup groups around the area for things that interest you and potential job opportunities as well. You got to get out there and meet people, because the typical employer, they usually hire based on recommendations of others or people that they know before they go out to the other job sites and kind of place their bets on just resumes.
But
so try and network more.
What about retraining, relocating? You mentioned networking. What industries that are still struggling? You know, we have these young people who are entering the job market. They're having a rough time breaking into some of those where older people are having a little trouble staying. They're leaving before retirement.
Right, they are. I mean, look, the biggest advice I have when people are looking for work, it's not the industry that matters so much, it's the company, Joyce. It's how the company is run, it's what they're investing in, how they treat their employees, and how they're being innovative and competitive going forward. So if you're looking for a job and you're looking, you've got some skill set, you want to try and find a job at a company that really fits you. And whether or not that takes a little retraining, okay, that's something that might be required. But you're looking for those companies that are looking forward.
Okay, so what's on the horizon, industries that people can start training for now?
In the Philadelphia area in particular, I love to talk about healthcare because healthcare is absolutely growing. Technology companies, particularly if you're an application developer and you talk about retraining, Joyce, that's a great thing to get training in. Security, because people are really concerned about that. Construction is also a great place to get skills. And here's two other things that I think are of real interest to small businesses that are looking to hire. Translation services. As so many companies have grown to do work overseas, having a skill set in another language like Spanish or even Mandarin, huge. And finally, an enormous growth going on around the country and in this area in animal care.
Really?
An increase in veterinary services as well as services for all of our pets. There's always certain opportunities there. So look for companies that are in those industries. You might find some opportunities for yourself.
And look for Gene. He's hiring too. All right. Thanks so much, Gene, for joining us tonight. A lot of good tips. All right.
Take care.
See you later. Okay. Well, firefighters use their equipment for a little fun. It's a good old-fashioned water fight. Check this out. But more is at stake here than just getting wet. What these guys are fighting for. Plus, up close and personal with Lady Liberty, a new exhibit.